I'm Richie. I come from Latvia. I love music so much that I had to do something about it. And eventually that took me to playing just for other people, because I had the question, why doesn't anybody just pay money for enjoying music? And then I discovered what the DJ does, and I realized, okay, this is for me. And that happened.
It happened like a year ago when I was in Ljubljana and we invited a Latvian guy to DJ this underground party. It didn't go so well because the cops came three times and we just have to leave to the after party, and there we had a lot of fun. And I saw him using this software that I'm going to show you later. It's called Traktor. And basically, if you have it and you have MP3 file music in your computer, you can just play music for everyone. You don't need any fancy equipment, really. But some equipment is always useful. So the first thing that a DJ for sure needs is a pair of speakers. And it's extremely nice, especially if you play electronic music, if you have a subwoofer, which is this nice thing. Because music for a DJ goes in different frequencies. So you get the high frequencies, which are like the single sounds, like the ch-ch-ch. And then you get the middle, and then you get the low frequencies, which are the bass. And that for that you need the big subwoofer. Okay, so the next thing that connects the DJ to the speakers is a mixer. And this thing already does the frequency thing, so I can control the frequencies as I want. And depending on what kind of a DJ you are, will tell what other equipment are using. For example, how it all started back in the day was with vinyls. And when people played vinyl, they needed a turntable, which is actually two turntables, so you can mix two songs at the same time. So you have two of these on each side of this thing. And for example, one turntable here goes to this channel, and the other one goes to this channel. And then you control different frequencies of the song. So you have one song playing, and the job of the DJ is to make the transition from one song to the other as smooth as possible.
So there are some you can try. YouTube parts, Sven and me, translation. So we will continue with translation.
Začal vysvětlovat, že aké vlastně příslušenstvo DJ potřebuje. Najprv tam byl subwoofer, čo je vlastně zariadenie, které vysiela basy. A je to vlastně typ reproduktorů, jako by. Hlavně elektronický DJ potřebují toto, lebo elektronický hudba se velmi stará z basov, které vlastně udávají rytmus. Potom tam byl mixer, right? Mixer, tam to vlastně spája DJ-a s jeho reproduktormi. Tam si môže nastavovať frekvencie, ktoré budú hrané reproduktormi, sú zapojené reproduktory. A ďalej, ako to všetko začalo, pri vinylových platniach, čiže ľudia potrebovali vinylové spinnery, potrebovali dva, aby mohli z jednej pesničky prechádzať na druhú. Richie?
Yeah, so after the vinyl times, somebody invented this thing called a CDJ. And first it was for CDs, so in the old versions, and still with the new ones, but like you put a CD here, and then you did exactly the same as you did with vinyls, but it was more digital and you had more flexibility. It wasn't so difficult as with vinyls, because playing vinyls is really like an art on its own. I'm still not in that field. Like, some people are crazy for vinyls because of many different properties of how it sounds and how you play it. But yeah, usually when you see a DJ, they are using these, and nowadays they use USB flash drives, where they have the digital music, like in MP3 files, or preferably in WAV format.
Čiže po vinyloch prišli takéto zariadenia, ktoré sa volajú CDJ. Ako to začalo, bolo, že vlastne tam od spodu sa nasunulo CDčko a potom sa po každej pesničke vlastne menili. Dnes už, a potom to fungovalo ako normálny vinyl, že vlastne tým sa točilo a tým sa skračovalo. Dnes už to funguje tak, že sa tam nahrá hudba z USBčka, z flash drive-u, a preferovaná forma je WAV súbor, kvôli kvalite, ale niektorí ľudia stále preferujú vinily a sú to vlastne tí, ktorí sú vlastne najviac skúsení. A Richie vlastne povedal, a za to rozumiem hovoriť v prvé osobe, lebo to je divné, že jemu sa, on ešte nie je na tom leveli, aby vlastne hral na viniloch, ale niektorí to preferujú kvôli tomu zvuku a tej technike.
Alright, so the newest generation, which I'm kind of where I started, is using not the CDJs and a mixer and a flash drive, but to actually use a computer where you have all the music, and then you have a software, like an application, where you control the music and all the frequencies. And for that, like, so the DJ doesn't have, like, on the laptop during the performance, we use these things. Like, I have like a smaller one. But for the software that I am using called Traktor, because you play tracks and Traktor, this beat machine is super nice. Like, my friend has two of them actually. And yeah, it basically has almost all of the buttons that the software has. And like, yeah, it's, you feel like in a spaceship and you're controlling the ride.
Čiže najnovšia generácia DJ-ov používa vlastne software na počítači a takýto panel. Vlastne toto je jeden z takých tých krajších a môj kamarát má dokonca dva. Vlastne kontroluje toto isté, čo kontroluje software, a keď to používate, tak sa cítite ako vesmírne lodi, stlačíte všetky tlačítka a vlastne robíte niečo pekné.
Yeah, this is one kind, and I have a picture of another one, like Traktor is one software, then you have Serato, and some people prefer either one, I prefer Traktor. And then, yeah, this is the one I use, which is perfect for traveling, because the other one I had with the case, it weighs like 15 kilos, and it's been many times when I'm like going down the street with a huge box, and it's a pain in the... So I just use this that I can fit in my backpack, and it's awesome.
Podľa ten predchádzajúci obrázok, to bol vlastne ďalšia verzia toho, to má tiež vlastne spinnery na rôzne pesničky. A je to vlastne iné firmy a prvný software, prvý bol Traktor a druhý bol Serato. Ja preferujem teda Serato a vlastne teda Traktor, preferujem Traktor. Hej, a potom je tam tá ďalšia vec, čo je taký akýby cestovacia verzia. Lebo niekedy som nosil ten veľký, ale tá celý ten batok, ktorý vážil tak 15 kg. A teraz keď si zoberiem to, tak je veľmi jednoduché to proste dať so sebou a robiť to, čo potrebujem.
So, and sometimes like the DJs who play different types of, use different types of equipment, like vinyls or CDJs or digital, they're like, oh, like, usually the digital ones I look down to because they, like, you don't have to do much, you just press some buttons and it's not a lot of skill. But for me, I don't care, like, with the software you can do so many different things that it's way more fun for me and I can do a lot more with the dance party.
Takže je vlastne veľa druhov tohoto náradia vlastne a niektorí odsudzujú tie digitálne.
This is the new one. And there's a joke now about the DJs who play like I do, like using a laptop. It's called the Serato face, because one of the applications is called Serato. And when they're performing, sometimes you're like so focused in your screen that you're like this. And it's called the Serato face. If you Google it, it's really good.
Teraz je taký populárny vtip, hlavne na internete, volá sa to Serato Face, pretože jedna z tých aplikácií z tých softwarov, čo sa používa na mixovanie, sa volá Serato. A niektorí tí DJ sú do toho až takí vtiahnutí, že vlastne celé vystúpenie vyzerajú tak, že sa pozerajú do tej obrazovky. A keď si to vygooglíte, tak je to fakt vtipné.
Okay, so now moving on about what a DJ actually does. Like I said, the main idea is to mix from one song into another in as nice and smooth way as possible. But the other thing is to actually create a nice and pleasant experience on the dance floor for everybody who comes to dance. So you have to kind of read the crowd, you have to keep to a certain feeling that the people come for the party, otherwise they come, they think like you don't know what you're doing, or they just don't like the party and they leave. And this is all up to a DJ. This is why clubs always want a good DJ. This is why they pay them a lot of money, so they actually keep the people in the party.
Presuneme sa k praktickej časti. Vlastne čo DJ robí a čo dobrý DJ robí, je, že musí sa držať istého tempa, musí čítať ten DAW a musí vedieť, kedy vlastne čo zahrať, aby udržal ten, ten celkový pocit toho davu. A zlý DJ napríklad spraví to, že vlastne ľudia mu odídu z toho vystúpenia a preto veľké kluby platia veľa peniazí pre dobrých DJov, aby sa toto nestalo a aby všetci ľudia mali dobrý zážitek.
Another thing DJs usually do as like a thing of their own is they actually collect music. So they're in a way they're collectors. So if they have a certain a tendency towards certain music, they will like compart them into different feelings or genres or whatever. So for example, my collection on my computer, as you can see, is 2,500 different songs, and it's just like all kinds of different songs. And a big job is to actually manage them, to be able to find what you need as you're playing. So I actually improvise a lot and I don't like playing the same songs in, like many times, so I always need new music, I always need kind of, yeah, introduce something new. So I have to work a lot with my own playlist and I have to know how to find the songs that I, or the feelings that I want to produce in the party.
Čo DJ taktiež robí, je, že zbiera hudbu, zbiera si, tvorí si svoju knižnicu. Ja mám napríklad svojom počítači teraz 2500 rôznych pesniček a čo fakt nerad robím, je, že hrám rovnaké pesničky viacej krát na rôznych vystúpeniach, čiže stále hľadám novú a novú hudbu.
And then of course there's many different DJs because they play many different music and I also have a diverse playlist and how I do it is that every song that I put in my playlist, I add my own labels. Like the regular genres like house or techno or cumbia or latino, it doesn't work that well for me, so I kind of put my own labels that I can understand. And this software is very nice because I can search. So for example, I want to play ambient music. I just write ambient and then it shows me all the songs that I have labeled as ambient. Or for example, something deep. Like deep is not a genre, but it's a feeling. And I pull some songs with deep, and then I can just improvise some song that for me comes deep.
Čo DJ taktiež musí robiť, je, že si spraví poznámky svojim pesničkám. Napríklad ja robím to, že si dám do poznámok žáner, aby som rýchlo mohol nájsť pesničku, ktorú potrebujem zahrať. Čiže napríklad tam mám veci ako downtempo, techno, house alebo deep. Deep vlastne nie je žáner, ale je to taký pocit skorej. Čiže ak chcem pokračovať v nejakom žáneru, ktorý bol začatý, tak iba do vyhľadávania sa tam žáner a vyskočí mi to.
OK, so... Yeah, let's just play some music now. One genre that I really, really like, it's called cumbia, and now in the last few years there's been a lot of producers who make electronic cumbia, so for example, when a band who plays like Latino music, when they record, their beat is not perfect, so if I'm mixing two songs, it will not match, but people who make it electronically, it will be perfectly in sync. So this software also, for example, up here in the corner there's a button sync, and this one also, and now if I play them both together, they will be in sync, for example, which is... Oh, and here I have a loop, so the song is on, it just loops. And then I find another song that I've labeled as cumbia. This one, for example. Another thing you can see already is that here, there's this number that we call BPM or beats per minute, and it's basically the speed of the song. So this song is 93 beats per minute. This one is 84, but thanks to this button and the software, I can make this exactly as fast as this one. So they will match. So now I also make a loop here, and with the push of one button, sounds like one song playing. And yeah, with these loops I can also control the song, so it makes it really, really easy. Yeah, about the frequency, so yeah.
Yeah, here still. Stále som tu. Vlastne jeden žáner, ktorý preferuje kumbia. veľa, veľa živých takto hrákofiu a je dosť ťažké, pretože to ten rytmus nie je dokonalý prejsť z jednej pesničky na druhu, ale producenti elektronickí, ktorí robia elektronickú kumbiu, DJ potom si môžu na väčšie softwarech a vlastne hardwarech je taký, také tlačítko, že sync, to znamená synchronizovať. Stačím toho tlačítka sa vlastne synchronizujú beaty a rýchlosti tej pesničky. Napríklad to číslo, ktoré ti ukázal, to sa nazýva BPM, alebo beats per minute, alebo utiery za minútu, vlastne to udáva rýchlosť tej pesničky. Tá prvá bola 93,50 euro za minútu, druhá bola o niečo nižšia, ale stačím tlačítka vlastne sa dá vyrovnať a teraz to vlastne znie, ako by to bola jedna pesnička.
Yeah, about the frequencies, like to mix one song from the other, you have to be aware what's playing. And this software, again, it shows me what frequencies are playing just by the color of the waves that you can see. So the red color is the low frequencies, the bass. So now I have them turned off, as you can see here, the low frequencies are turned down. And as I turn them up, you can start feeling the lower frequencies. Okay, I'll make it louder. And the other one doesn't have so much red color, so it's not as bassy. But it still has some. So does the low frequencies, then you can hear